viene del mundo antes que en el camino de Jesucristo. Amén. Amén. It's nice to be here. I can only speak for myself. I have been blessed. Prayer is one thing that sets men apart from the rest. They say, don't join the rest because the rest are resting. The secret is prayer. Somewhere, but see, the world is yet to see a man who is fully led by God. So in other words, live and sing agaboni lutho, until the prayerful man and the prayerful woman, rise to the occasion. So I thank the Lord that we have the opportunity to come and fellowship and pray. And I believe that governing great who have been sitting down for years, they know the results that come with the prayer. Amen.
Amen.
The message they will share manje, I'm sure it's a farewell message.
Amen.
So it's more like umphako that you must take home. So you think of this, you look for something to encourage the church on what I live by now every day, So that's why sometimes I say preaching should not be difficult. You are sharing the experience that you've been having with God. You don't have to go to my encyclopedia and go to the library to search for a sermon. You just look at the experience that you are having with God, how God is taking you through to my day-to-day challenges. And then you capacitate the church now. This is how you must behave when you face a dilemma or a predicament. So that's my duty for today, and I don't think it should be long as well. We are looking at Mark chapter 16. Mark chapter 16, we'll read from verses 1, verses 4. Mark chapter 16, verses 1, verses 4. Mark in the New Testament, verses chapter 16, verses 1 to 4. Now it reads as follows. I'm reading from the King James Version. It says, "And when the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, had brought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him." Verses 2. "And very early in the morning," underline this one, not a borrowed Bible. It's Lana, "and very early in the morning, first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun." Underline it, verse 2. Verses 3, "And they said among themselves, who shall roll us away the stone from the door of the sepulchre?" And verses 4, which I like so much. It's, "And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great."
Amen.
I pray that these are your children, long before Kosi creation, and before Siva Kone, you knew which one day will be here. So I pray, of course, that you may speak what you want them to hear, and mute my mouth, and fill this place with your Holy Spirit. Our entrance to this place should not be the same as our exit. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now, now go to the passage there now, Mark chapter 16, where Kumburago to Jesu was dead. I like to use that word dead because, the development is through the development of the language. It has brought many things that I shifted the meaning of it death to itself. We say, he has passed on. That means he has gone somewhere. He has passed on and he is late. I don't understand what it means. But at the time, this time which Jesus was what was dead. I know it's very prevalent. They like to say someone has passed on. And the question is, where have they gone to? The person is dead. Satan and I, you shall not surely die.
Yes.
So some of the things that we use, they support some of those doctrines that we insinuated. So this time around, Jesus, Ushoni, dead. There is no breath. The plug, the switch is off. So Jesus Kumbule, he was a breadwinner, if you want to call him. He was a tuck shop in the wilderness for the disciples when they were hungry. You know, we were in medical aid. More than Jesus. Any small sickness, he was there for them. You know, the powerful insurance ever alive on earth. I don't think even a king insurance can match the insurance the one I match Jesus. Even when the car breakdown, not months ago.
Yeah.
If Jesus was there at that time when they had cars, he was the mechanic.
Yeah.
So it was everything that they needed as human beings. They never even needed their profession with two bag as fishermen. You know, if you have Jesus, you have everything. I was in together. So what happens with Kufuya's cards in that corner, the very source of their provider is now dead. Like I said, Jesus is no more. In fact, when you read the Bible, Linebu suggests that would say for almost 3 or 4 times Jesus was here, there will come a time where I'll go to Jerusalem and I'll be crucified, and on the third day I'll rise. If you read Matthew 16, Peter, we are denials. No, Lord, you shall not surely die. I was still together. So for 4 times, they did not get the message that Christ, your fears cards, where Christ would be no more. So they still denied it. They lived in denial that this thing may happen. And sometimes, Nazi, you know, it happens. As I said yesterday, there are others who believe once you have Christ, you will never have problems. You live in denial. I was still together. And hence, whenever a small problem happens, you say to yourself, this cannot be from God. I was still together. And as Bandavani Mbash would say, you know, it is somehow a defining point if you want to continue with your religion or your religion is coming to an end. If you do not anticipate my problems, I was still together. You know, and when you read the Bible, you find there are other problems which are God designed for us to go through them. You know, one of our problems that we bring to ourselves. You know, I always say, John, we have 2 chapters. I was still together. John, but how many name? Chapter 1, chapter 2, John, I didn't leave, and that's the end. I was still together. But because of disobedience, and living in denial, I refuse that the reality that he has to go and preach. There are 4 chapters in the book of John. Unnecessary chapters that has to talk the issue of disobedience. I was still together. In the belly of a fish. Unnecessary chapters. I was still together. So there are problems which are God designed, and there are other problems that we bring to ourselves, which were not part of God's plan. I was still together. You know, and but when you go into any kind of a problem, it's necessary to know which one. Maybe one day when we'll talk about the 3 different kinds of troubles. You know, the ones that we bring ourselves, the ones that are God designed, and the ones that just because you are a Christian, I was still together, and you are living in this earth, which always a man who is born of a woman is short-lived but full of what? Of troubles. So those ones, they come not because you have sinned, not because you have done anything wrong. You know, more your calls ready, there's a traffic, you're getting late to church or you are rushing for a meeting. It's not because you have sinned, but it's simply because you are living in a world that is full of trouble. I was still together. Hence, you face this problem. Sometimes you go to withdraw him, and I remember myself, you know, a card in Kunya machine. I was still together. You come back, the card was expired. You look at the dates, yes, it was expired, but there was no warning. I was still together. So there are those problems which you must not take personally. You know, and this was one of them. Ujesu is late, he was here to fulfill the mission, and Ujesu is now dead. So the women, because they cared about Jesus, now I looked at the reason, why do they have, they call it the embalming process. Why did they have to go and put spices on a body that is already dead? I was still together. You know, there is no sense why of spices, because Ujesu is already dead. You know, but they decided to say, let us go and put the spices. Now, when you read, there is no apparent reason why. But that's why my Bible scholars, they are suggesting that maybe these women were showing, they were extending the honor to Christ. I was still together. So, we still honor you even when you are dead. But there is no particular reason. We'll come back to that point. You know, so they went anyway to embalm Jesus. And then verses 2, verses 1, and very early in the morning, and the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre, at the rising of the sun. Now these are the women I was sitting together, and the Bible it is on a Sunday. Very early in the morning, they are rising to look for Jesus. The second was that. Many women on a Sunday, they'll be worried about the house chores. You know, I need to clean this, I need to do that, I need to wash these clothes. But these particular women, on a Sunday, little Bible, they rose up early to look for Jesus. And I want to place a challenge as well. You know, not only to more women, I was still together, but this should be our daily routine. Very early in the morning, the first thing that we must look for is Jesus. You know, the Bible talks about the wise men who came from the east. And, you know, I take some joy because the east is Mpumalanga of Africa. You know, so it's the Bible, the wise men came from the east. So I also come from Mpumalanga. Amen. So that is why I take some joy. But, you know, the Bible says the wise men came from the what? From the east. So in other words, if you are looking for wise people, it's the Bible that says, but the people with the Polish theology, they say, no, these people were not wise because they came from the East. There were many astrologers who came from the East in those times, but they were not recorded as the wise men. But these people, they were wise simply because they were looking for Jesus. So regardless where you come from, I was still together. So long as you are looking for Jesus, the Bible considers you a wise man. Yeah. Yeah. I even say, regardless of your bank status, how much is in your bank account? So long as you are looking for Jesus, the Bible considers you a what? A wise man or a wise woman. So this is what I feel it should be a habit of every Christian. You know, the first thing that you do in the morning and the last thing that you do before you sleep tells you who is your God. The first thing that you do, it tells you who's your what? Who's your God? You know, I've made it a habit myself, putting Vuka long before everyone wakes up, you know, and just commune with the Lord. You know, it is prayer that anchors our faith in Christ. You know, you can have everything, but if you don't pray, a prayerless week make one weak. That's why people come to church powerless, to a powerful place, and leave the church in powerless. It is because of in prayer. I will sit together. If you lack in prayer, then you can't sustain yourself in your Christian walk. So this woman, this Bible, they would rise up early in the morning. In fact, even if you have kids, I encourage my parents to wake up early before and consecrate your children to the Lord. I do this, you know, my wife used to be up and early, not anymore. You know, she would sleep now and sleep. I have to wake her up. It's 7 or 8, but she was still together. You know, but she used to wake up and pray with me. What I wonder, what I do, so while she is sleeping, I go and pray for that child.
Amen.
I read my Bible, this is Bible, and I'm, Christ was filled with the Holy Spirit in his mother's womb. Go and read to Matthew chapter 2. And whose responsibility to inject the Holy Spirit? It's us parents. You know, and some of us, we leave them for too long and discover it. We say, so rise up early before everyone avoga. Pray over them. Sprinkle the blood of Christ over the family. You know, so these women, they want an interest. We see, early in the morning, even if it's Sunday. But the first thing, before I do anything, I must have seen my God. And then it's a Bible, they had a problem, even though they were prayerful, even though they were looking for Christ. The problem here was, who will roll for us the stone away? It's a question. You know, though they were excited and enthusiastic to see Christ, but you are here, now I've made my small research. In fact, when you read the previous chapter, Matthew, Mark 6:15. We have Jenna, you know, the stone never by fire on the tomb. You know, it was rolled by men. Yes, it's a good idea. These are women for crying out loud. You know, and oftentimes I know we say women are soft. They have their way when they are strong. It's a good idea. When I look at how a woman sustains, you know, impregnates. I am almost like a pharas to say, I thank God I'm not a woman. And that's why I realized women are strong. you know, on other things where men can never be strong. If Ngunkulu were to say we must give birth, Dr. Monotone, I promise you, if it would happen, it would happen once and it will never happen again. If I'm a man, it's the second of us. But Ngunkulu, because you understand that now more women, they have their own strength that can never level the strength of a man. But when it comes to the physical strength, they are weaker than men. That is why at times they don't understand, you know, mermaids who have the guts and, you know, women are brave to lay a hand on a woman. Don't do physically weak. In fact, if you do that, you are showing that you are insecure. It's a man who is announcing what insecurity when you lay a hand on it. You know, I understand, you see. Sometimes it's not easy to tell people to separate, you know. But you want to mark child, I don't know, Bazaar. You know, I've seen the West. I think you are safe away from that person. You know, while they are fixing their own way. You know, but the point that I'm making, would say women are weak physically. You know, when they have to push stones and whatever, you know, it's not their duty. And the stone from the Bible in chapter 15, it was rolled by men. I even went on the internet and I researched, but it was 1,000 to 2,000 pounds.
Yeah.
You know, if one converter, that's even like 4,000 to 6,000 kgs. You know, so it was a big stone. It was many human beings combined. You know, I don't know what size, but something that is 4,000 pounds is too big. But these women, irregardless of their fear, who will roll the stone for us? They went on. They are teaching us if faith, even though life is difficult, life must continue. I want it because it's really difficult, then you sleep on your bed and you say, oh Lord, have mercy on me. No, rise up and let life continue. And a lot of people, it's sad to see, would see, at this question, what committed suicide? Would you have the breadwinner? My father is dead, or my mother, or both parents were having a car accident. Then the next thing, Munda committed suicide. At this question, who shall roll the stone for me away? You know, they've become drug addicts. We are dealing with another case, mind you, of another gentleman. You know, I think I have to go and study psychology. You know, or what the order they'll advise me. But, you know, one of my cases are serious when it comes to marital issues. Your brother, Wakula, Umamwake, Azanam Jera, Uzubaba, Ubani, the mother was a heavy, you know, drinker. And Wakula in an orphanage home, Walu Mama corner, because the mother couldn't support, you know, and then Wakula, Wakula, Mama was shown. Just Makshana, Mama, the man went heavy into drugs. You know, and somehow, Asamara, no Christ, I'm converter, and he got married. Back into drugs.
Oh.
You know, Kumbula the same thing, and all those things. I was still together. Now the woman is planning a divorce. And the man is saying, no, you can't divorce me, man. You know, it's a very difficult situation. The woman is saying, I have to protect my kids. The man is saying, I have to protect my marriage, even though I'm a drunkard. Now he's saying, I need counseling and all of that. So the point is, Bandu, at this question, who will roll the stone for us away? They've become worse than what they should have been. Just when you look at the difficult, the animosity or lubanzima, you know, people decide to do the worst things as if they are bringing a solution while their solution is a problem. But oh, I thank God that we have a friend that sticks closer than a brother. You know, every time when this question comes, I look unto Jesus. You know, because he is the solution to all our problems. You know, I don't know what you are going through, but what I know is that Jesus is the answer. The beautiful thing when you read in Luke, sent a mighty angel. I was still together. You know, one day I pray, you know, when I get to heaven, I think I'll have a week where I want to thank God for the angelic assistance in my life. If it were not for God's angels, I was still together.
Yeah.
That is why sometimes I say, you know, if verses that if God is for us, who can be against us? The point is that there is never a time when God is not on our side. If there will ever be a day, now get this in your head, if there is ever a day when God will not be on our side, I am saying the devil can go on vacation and send one of his limping demons to destroy you. Is that what I was asking? If we have a tool, Satan wants to kill you any second from now. So there is never a time, even on your worst day, God is still on your side. Is that what I was asking? So there is never a problem. Is when you read other sources, Nkulunkulu keeps the earth in the palm of his hand. So if the earth itself is in the palm of God's hand, I equal problem, then Akshaya, it keep it from the planet Earth. Even if you keep up planet Earth, you still fall on God's hand. I was still together with that. Yeah. So Jesus becomes the solution to the problem. Now when you look at this verse, verses 4, it's, and when they looked, they saw that the stone was, it uses the word was, which is a past tense.
Yeah.
It was around, you know, what God has revealed to me, it makes me excited to face any problem.
Yeah.
Is that what I was about? What one eagle, how it behaves. Eagles are not afraid of a storm. What's the eagle? My one storm, yes, approach. And then it rises above. I will see it together. And then, must I figure above, it then floats using the storm. So, eagle uses less strength in a storm because it floats using the storm. Is that what I was about? It doesn't run from the storm, it faces the storm and uses the stone to even float. When life throws stones at you, take them and put them for a foundation. The higher the building, the deeper the foundation. So the more the challenges you face, the more, the stronger your foundation will be. So it's a pipe belly. When they looked, they saw that the stone was. If I can tell you now what's the problem, no one and I, it's past tense in God. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
The problems that you are facing today, it is past tense with God. Now let me take you to Second Kings chapter 6. 1 Kings chapter 6, verses 15 going down. This is Bible. And when the rise young man rose up 8 in the morning, you know, others were saying he was going to fetch water. Others were saying he was going to pee. You know, and he noticed a great host of army. Now remember, the king of Israel, the king of Syria. I was still together. So every time when the king wanted to be king, Israel. So a prophet would go and alert the king and say, there's some people who are coming to kill you. And then the king would run. I was still together. And it happened several times. Every time my fear and goes to Syria, he couldn't find the king of Israel. Then the Bible says, he then inquired, who amongst us is telling the king our plans, that we have a plan to kill him? And they said, no, there is a man in Israel who hears what you do while he's in Israel in your room. I will see it together. A soldier is revealing to the king, there is a man who is in Israel. Whatever you are doing in your home, he knows.
Yeah.
He is the one who is telling the king your next plan. And it's a Bible, let us go and kill that person.
Yeah.
It's a Bible, why I'm surrounded by Elijah. I love the faith that Elijah in this instance. This is Bible, why I am surrounded. And as they have surrounded him, the young man of would say, lo and behold, a whole host of army with their chariots. They were ready for him to come out and destroy. And this obeyed him over your color. Alas, master, what must we do? This is Bible. And he prayed that the Lord opened his eyes.
Oh!
So in this thing, I was in trouble. It's for our eyes to be open. I was still together. Sometimes we don't need our problems to be solved. We need the spiritual eyes to look at our problems. I hear a song that says, what you thought was a mountain, it was only a hill on heaven's point of view. This is the quote I was at. The thing that was making you cry, Lizulu is even getting confused, but this is only a hill. And you, with your physical eye, you are seeing a mountain. This is the quote I was at. So this is the Bible, Elijah would open his eyes. Now listen to this one. This is Bible, I mean, see. This is Lana. when his eyes were open, immediately, I don't know, maybe I need to go back and do English 101, but the Itilana in English, immediately, he noticed another host of army that surrounded Elijah and even their enemies. My Bible is not saying, as he opened his eyes, he saw angels coming down. I was in together. Or he saw a host of army coming. I was in together. You see, they were already there. Relaxed. Waiting to see what next move the devil is planning to do. What am I saying? My problems were to that we go through. They have to squeeze themselves around solutions to find us. Am I the only one who have a crazy faith to believe this? Before allows the problem to come your way, wait, devil, and he places all the solutions. When I read Ellen White, Unkulunkulu has 1,000 solutions to one problem. The problem is that we only see one. And if it does not answer on that one, we panic. He has thousands. I was still together. So every time when I'm in trouble, I say, Lord, open my eyes. I believe there's something I'm not seeing. Sometimes you will complain when God is there with his whole host of army. Remember Mary, Mark Fior Jesus, what color in the presence of solution? If you have been here, but I'm here now. Why are you still crying? We cry even in the presence of solution. When God has already answered your prayer, but the problem is you don't see. Who are with your naked eyes? So what do we need when we're in trouble? We need the Lord to open our eyes. Because it is the heaven's perspective that changes. Sometimes the Bible may not change your situation, but it changes your heart to react differently to your situation. This is the corner was
asking.
It's by Peru, figure the stone was. What's in Isaiah 65? Before they call, I will answer. While they are speaking, I will hear. That's the God we serve. So every time when I go through problems, I was still together. I remember, you know, last year we ended one contract of one brother. You know, I've employed and fired Adventist. Amen. You know, because I need you with amen. You know, I employ Adventists. And if they don't deliver, I fire them.
You
know, so we are here to work. I was still together. Mzalwane, you work. Laziness is equivalent to sin. So I ended one contract of an Adventist last year. And the whole year this year, I was all by myself. My wife is doing the accounts and quotation, the follow-ups and all of that. Who has paid, who has not. But now, we're in a situation that she was in and out, and I had to look at everything. I was still together. And the stress of the work was overwhelming. You know, and it's amazing. While I was in that predicament, for 6 months, I didn't have a staff. I was doing everything. I would quote, go and mount, track other things I do. You know, quote aloud design. You have your printer from printing. You have your father from go far away to your client to invoice. I was still together, all by myself. And I was asking myself, as Ufiwa Lundwana, who will roll the stone away from me? Mr. Kwan was out. And it was becoming overwhelming. What are interesting, Woodsy, at least in that short term of difficulty, you know, it turned over, it was much better than when we had clients. I mean, the staff working for us. The second was when you are expected to underperform, you are overperforming. That is the presence of the Lord in our lives. So, since I was here, 2 weeks ago, I was praying, I was always telling my wife, Woodsy, you know, because we've interviewed people. You know, the whole of this year we've been interviewing people. They have high demands, but less capability. You know, 10,000 is like my brother. I still have to teach you this thing. You don't know it. That's no, but I need this man. So we can't agree. We interview another one. The second one was it was becoming difficult. You know, I'm doing normal Bible study. The KNFC has employed me as a Bible worker in the English area. You know, Makalas and Indians. So every night, Monday, I have to go and do a study. Tuesday is prayer. Wednesday is Bible study. Thursday is Bible study. And I was asking myself, who will roll the stone away from me? Yeah.